And now we will learn how landlords manage their items list.
If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time.
What is an item? Well, an item is a service or product that one sells to a customer, in this case, our tenants. An item is something that you would list in the body of a sales receipt or an invoice when you make that sale. Each item is connected to an income type of account in the chart of accounts. Every time an item is placed on an invoice, the income account for that item goes up. For example, Holden wants to list late fees on a tenant's invoice separately so that the tenant can see how much she or he is being charged specifically for late fees compared to the rest of the regular rent. He also wants to track the income from late fees separately so he can know the total he earned just from late fees. He wants to be able to compare that to how much he earned from the overall rent. He must create an item on the items list called late fees. And when he creates this item, he must connect it to the income account in the chart of accounts called income from late fees. So if you look at the diagram, on the right is the pretend invoice that we would imagine giving the customer, the tenant, to ask them to pay for the rent. Now, when we list the monthly rent, $500, that means when we record this particular invoice, this account in the chart of accounts should go up by $500 because that's where it gets recorded. However, if we add a late fee for $1.50, that means that $1.50 should instead be recorded in this account, income from late fees. This way he can get the separate totals of each account and know how much he earned from rent compared to how much he earned from late fees. So let's take a look how to put it into QuickBooks. So from where we are now, we're going to click sales and go down to products and services. Now, of course, this is the very first time that we're going to this window. So we're going to click add a product or service. Okay, now we're just going to choose service because rent and things like late fees are basically just services. Now, the name of this service will be rent due because that's how it will appear on the invoice when you give it every month. Now you don't have to put a category and you don't have to put a picture or any of these other extra details. In fact, you can leave sales price or rate blank and fill in the rent when you do tenant by tenant each time you make an invoice. But the account that should automatically increase when you earn rent and give an invoice acknowledging that you earn rent, that account is an income type of account up here, and it is rental income earned. So every time you choose this item on an invoice to give to a tenant, this is the account that will go up by the amount you put on the invoice. And of course, we want to click save and new, and you'll see in a moment that is on the list behind us. And then of course, the next one will be late fees. And of course, we want to connect late fees to the account called income from late fees, which is here. So these are the accounts in the chart of accounts that we put in the previous video, and the specific one that increases when we charge a tenant a late fee, or maybe just singular late fee, because that's how it will look when you put it on the invoice. And of course, we're going to click now, save and close, and the full item list is behind us. These are all the things that we could potentially put on an invoice. Now, let's just finish by making inactive the ones that we don't want to see. Hours and sales don't relate to us, so we'll make them inactive. And I'll even make inactive the late fee item so that we can activate it later when we get up to the video that teaches us about late fees. So as a batch action, we can make them inactive and click yes. Now, for some reason, it won't let us make inactive the two that QuickBooks gave, but we can ignore and disregard them. But if we want to see the ones that have been made inactive, we would click the filter funnel and change status from active to either inactive or all. And if we click all, now we can see that late fee is still on the list, but it just says deleted. We can just come here and click, come to the right where it says make active and click make active. And now there it is back on the list, and we can clear the filter and see it's showing only the active ones and late fee is active. So again, click here, edit, arrow pull down, make inactive, click yes, and we will reactivate the late fee when we get to that video.